So deep learning for me is getting the students to be thinkers and helping them be creative and not just consumers. So it's really allowed us to hear the voice of each student, which has been a big part of our year. That type of learning has allowed the students to have voice and become thinkers.
I think that's really important for our students, is that they're able to dig a little bit deeper in what they're learning and to be able to apply it to real life. And that's ultimately what we want our students to be able to do.
Now with all the six C's and what we're doing, like we did today, it really gets those ideas and puts them in your head better than copying something down on paper.
We know that people are not working in isolation anymore. Like, no one is sitting at a desk by themselves trying to solve a problem. You know, that people are joining together, looking at big world solutions. The world's a much smaller place. So as was said, that collaboration, that ability to think together and problem solve together is a hugely important life skill.
I kind of personally find like a hard time kind of communicating my ideas, but when you're working as a group, it kind of all is kind of easier to communicate together.
And I think they're seeing their purpose, and they're finding their place in the world where they belong. So that's really nice to see from a grade two perspective and from a grade six perspective. They're starting to see what impact they can make in the world.
It's really fun because like you have somebody to help you make it.
Yeah, you like working together with others?
For sure. And they have more experience so they can help us.
They're not afraid to take risks. Like, they're finding out that if I take a risk and something goes off, that's okay. My brain's gonna grow, they'll tell you that I have a growth mindset, I'm gonna approach the problem in a new way, I'm gonna ask other people. So that fear is much lower when they collaborate and get the critical thinking going together.
At the end of this year, my brain's gonna be huge. At the end of this
year, it's gonna be bigger than Albert Einstein.
And we think those skills are what they need, because we don't even know, the world is changing so quickly. There's so much information out there. We want them to be able to take that information and do things with it, create new things, or be critical thinkers about it. So what we're seeing in our students are what we're hoping will be the tools they need as they move forward.
In grade two, we do like the robots and like fun, really fun activities to learn that.
And what makes it fun in grade two is that we think we're not learning, but we actually are learning.
I think it's that I feel like I get to really know the students as people. I don't think I've ever known my students as well as I do now, because we're trying things in so many different ways that I get to appreciate them for who they are and all the different talents they have. And I've noticed in this year that no one says, oh, they're the smart kid, because they're all smart in so many ways. So that student might be the good coder, and that student might be really great at creating with boxes and creating something new. So I feel really connected to them as people, because I get to see them shine, even students who have a lot of needs. And we do have a lot of different needs in our classes, a wide spectrum of abilities and other learning needs, and yet they can all get in there, and they can all show what they know, and they can all shine, which is what makes me passionate about seeing that.